Who remembers PEMDAS? One person, rest of you blocked out the trauma. PEMDAS is the order of operations. Parentheses, exponents, multiplication, division, addition, subtraction. But we couldn't remember that, so we had to come up with a mnemonic device. Who remembers what that one is? Please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. Does anybody here have an Aunt Sally? No, because they stopped making them in the 70s, all right? They don't exist. You don't have an Aunt Sally, and if you do, why are you constantly excusing her? Aunt Sally either has a bladder problem or she's racist. It's one of the two. Please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. She's had a little too much to drink tonight. Aunt Sally's the one at the dinner table like, COVID and TikTok both come from please excuse my dear Aunt Sally.
Aftermath.
About three times a year on Twitter, you'll see it trending again. PEMDAS. And every time I think, finally, it's getting canceled. Then it turns out someone can't solve a fourth grade level math problem.
Question that's breaking the internet, okay? So I'm sure you've seen this on Facebook. There's significant disagreement in terms of what it is. Is it one? Is it nine?
And then everyone laughs. This idiot doesn't know PEMDAS? And then I laugh at the people laughing because that idiot is onto something. That's how I laugh. PEMDAS is completely arbitrary. It's not a law of the mathematical universe. It's a man-made law. Just like no swimming after eating or Sharia. For the record, I'm against both. Sure, we use it to clarify and organize expressions, but that's assuming that we even want that, which most of us don't care. PEMDAS is like the type A clinger in a relationship, always asking, what are we? You may say, but Sammy, how else are we going to tackle expressions like this? My question is, why do we need to tackle it in the first place? Homework? Name one other reason besides homework. Go ahead. I'll wait. Oh, look at that. You can't think of anything other than homework. No one even knows where it came from. It's man-made of unknown origin, like Subway tuna. COVID. But in the 19th century, it suddenly started appearing in our textbooks. From where? Who decided this arbitrary order that all humans bow to? I'll tell you who it was. In a moment, I have to explain things in order.
Oh, man.
Now, the PE in PEMDAS is intuitive. Obviously, parentheses look separated from the rest of an expression, and logically, what's inside them should be contained, like a dirty secret. It's like they say, what happens in parentheses stays in parentheses. And exponents are obviously stuck to one number, like it's baggage. So it makes sense these things would be addressed on their own. But the real arbitrary rule that makes PEMDAS is the choice to perform multiplication and division before addition and subtraction. The MDAS, if you will. And this choice is called the basic rule. Or the Becky rule for some of you. The basic rule traces back to the 1600s to a mathematician named Franz van Schooten. Now Franz was a very nice young man, intelligent, team player, generous, an overall well-intentioned guy. That is until 1632, when he met René Descartes. Descartes, of course, iconic French mathematician and philosopher, famous for the quote, I think, therefore I am. They met at the University of Leiden in Holland, where van Schooten was studying and doing one of his favorite pastimes that most of us do in math class, doodling. Upon seeing van Schooten's talents, Descartes approached him with a strange offer. He said, draw me. And so came one of the few portraits that exists of Descartes, as he was known for being extremely picky about his appearance and portrayal. No surprise that Descartes soon took van Schooten under his wing, bringing him into his elite math circle in Paris, including legends like Marin Massin, and of course, Descartes' known rival, Pierre de Fermat.
Oh, look, Fermat, he has a little theorem.
That's not the only thing that's little.
It is a normal size theorem.
Fermat, of course, brilliant, but constantly outshined by Descartes. And here's where it gets weird. Because Van Schooten was adored by all in the circle, Mersenne and Fermat allowed him to copy their manuscripts.
I think, therefore, I am unable to shave.
Oh.
Huh?
Uh-huh. Yeah, good. Yeah, I get it.
But Van Schooten and Descartes had an agreement that Van Schooten was to help him push his Cartesian geometry across Europe. And so when Van Schooten was ready to publish his learnings from Fermat, Descartes firmly rejected, even telling the publishers not to print it. So in 1646, Van Schooten finally published a piece which was obviously heavily influenced and approved by Descartes. The book was called Vieta, an ode to the late mathematician Francois Viète, whose transcripts were provided by Mersenne.
What's up? I'd like to thank God, first and foremost, you know, for letting us do math. Of course, Descartes, Van Schooten, Fermat? Not Fermat. Not him. Anyone but him. You know.
Okay. Hey!
This one's for you, Mom. Hey! I never knew my mom.
Which obviously was a slap in the face to Fermat. And this was the very book that introduced the basic rule to the world. So we're left with an unknown. Was it in fact Viète who thought of it? Or was it stolen from Fermat? Or was it all the mastermind of Descartes? Well, either way, Descartes controlled the publishers, and this was the rule that he wanted to be pushed onto the masses. But why? Well, take a look at the Cartesian model of mathematics, where everything is defined by its coordinates, whether it's an ordered pair on a plane or an ordered triplet in 3D. Everything has a trackable location. And thus, by launching PEMDAS, they could establish, you guessed it, a new world order of operations. Is that how you do it? After all, Descartes' general intention was to help humanity master and possess nature. And his Cartesian order, including PEMDAS, was part of this. An attempt to control the uncontrollable. So then why did PEMDAS not appear in our textbooks until the 19th century? Simple. Catholic Church. The Catholic Church caught on to Descartes in the late 1600s and banned his work.
Making arbitrary rules, that's our job!
But because Vieta was written by Van Schooten, it slipped through the cracks. And so while Cartesian thought is not unanimously embraced across the world, PEMDAS is. Any questions? Yeah, I need that pencil. So are you getting it? Do you see what I'm saying?
No.
I think therefore I'm a bore at parties.
That's kind of self-burn.
So, go over again.
Just want you to know, I'm against both.
Oh, really?